So in this video, I am going to explain about the unit 1, it is power supply concept. It is concerned to the analog electronic subject. It is for the third semester diploma. Okay, if you take the power supply, so initially it is to be classified into of the main two types. It is one is then, it is one is, one second. It's not sharing the screen. Wait here. Okay. So if you take the classifications of the power supply, it is to be classified into of the main two types. It is one is the it is unregulated power supply, and the another one is the another one is it is the regulated power supply. So in short, so it is called as an RPS. So if you take the unregulated power supply, means it is going to provide the variable DC. So that means that the output voltage of this regulated power supply, it is not going to be the constant. So according to the variation of the input voltage or according to the variation of the output load, okay, it is going to vary its output voltage. And if it is going to vary the output voltage, so it is itself is called as an unregulated power supply. Okay, and the another one is the RPS. RPS is the regulated power supply. It is going to provide the constant DC voltage source. So it is going to provide the constant DC voltage. It is with the irrespective of the variations in the main as well as the load here. Okay, so in general or in brief, if you take an unregulated power supply, it is having the variable DC voltage. If you take the regulated power supply, it is having the constant DC voltage. Okay, and if you take the need for the regulated power supply, so it is what is the need for the regulated power supply? So if you take the regulated, if you take an unregulated power supply, it is not good enough. So unregulated power supply is not good enough. It is because in unregulated power supply, it is having the poor regulation. So it is going to be cause, it is mainly due to the internal resistance of the power supply. Okay, so if the internal resistance of the power supply is going to vary, according to that, it is also going to vary the output voltage in case of the unregulated power supply. And the another one is the variation of the AC main supply. So as you all know that the AC mains which is coming from the main board is not the constant. It is going to fluctuating always. So according to that, the output voltage is also going to fluctuate in case of the unregulated power supply. And the another one is, it is the variations of the temperature. So according to the variations of the temperature also, so the output voltage, it is going to vary in case of the unregulated power supply. So if you want to make use of any of the power supply, it is for any of the electronic component, so it is mandatory to use the regulated power supply. So because in unregulated power supply, it is having the poor regulation, and the alterations of the output voltage takes place, it is mainly due to the variations of the AC main supply. And if any of the alterations in the temperature occurs, according to that, the output voltage is going to vary. So it can able to generate an inaccurate and the erratic operation of the supply. So in order to overcome all the above, the RPS is to be needed. In order to overcome the poor regulation, in order to overcome the variations in the AC supply, and in order to overcome the variations in the temperature, so the RPS is to be needed. Okay, if you see the block diagram of the RPS, so the RPS is to be implemented with the transformer, it is to be followed by the rectifier, it is to be followed by the smoothing circuit, it is to be followed by the regulator here. Okay, so all these components is to be required in order to implement the regulated power supply. So initially, the voltage from the AC mains is applied as input for the transformer. And in the regulated power supply, especially you are using the step-down transformer. So the step-down transformer is one, it is going to decrease the voltage level. So the voltage from an AC mains is up to 230 volts, and its amplitude is to be get decreased according to the output parameters of the step-down transformer. Either it may be 606, it may be 12012, it may be 18018, it may be 24024, etc. So according to the requirement of the user here. So what the operation of the step-down transformer it will do is, it is going to decrease the amplitude, or it is going to decrease the voltage level of the applied input or of the AC mains. So that it is to be represented with the waveforms. You can able to see the waveform. The input waveform is having the more amplitude if it is to be compared to the output of the transformer waveform. And output of the transformer is inputted into the rectifier. So you can able to see a rectifier is one of the electronic circuit. It is used to convert an AC voltage into the pulsating DC. Okay, the actual meaning of the pulsating DC is, it is the mixture of the DC and AC. And it is also called as the ripples. So the output of the transformer is inputted into the rectifier. And what the rectifier it will do, it is going to convert an AC voltage into the pulsating DC. So the amount of the AC is to be converted into the DC. And along with the DC, so the small amount of the AC is also present along with the DC, and it is itself is called as the ripples here. And after that, so if you want to see the representation of the pulsating DC, so that you can able to see the waveform which is to be represented as the rectified output here. And the output of the rectifier is to be inputted into the filter. And in this, what the filter it will do, it is going to act as the smoothing circuit, so that you can able to see the humps available in the rectified output. And it is to be get minimized, or it is to be get smoothened, it is by the smoothing circuit, and it is itself is called as the filter. And in this case, what it will do is, it is going to allow to pass only the DC. It passes only the DC, and it is going to block the AC. I say that the output of the rectifier, it is having the DC as well as the small amount of the AC. And that small amount of the AC is to be blocked by this filter here. And after that, in the output of the filter is called as the filtered output. And it is going to be inputted into the regulator. It is the important factor of the regulated power supply. So what this regulator it will do is, it is used to maintain the constant DC voltage. And the output of the regulator, if you want, means you can able to see in the waveform, it is to be indicated with a straight line, which is indicating as the pure DC output. Okay, earlier, so that you can able to see in the filtered output, it is some amount of the AC, it is some amount of the fluctuations, or it is the variable output. And it is to be get straightened, or it is to be maintained constant, it is by the regulator. And it is itself is applied to the load here. Okay, so again, I am going to review if you take the block diagram of the regulated power supply, it is to be implemented with the step-down transformer, rectifier, okay, filter, and the regulator. Okay, so the input from the AC main supply is applied as input to the step-down transformer. So the step-down transformer, it is used to decrease the voltage level. And the output of the step-down transformer is inputted into the rectifier. And the rectifier, it is used to convert an AC voltage into the pulsating DC. And the output of this rectifier is inputted into the filter. In this case, the filter is the smoothing circuit. And it is used to eliminate the ripples, okay, which is present at the output of the rectifier. And after that, it is used to pass it into the regulator. And it is used to maintain the constant DC voltage. And its output is applied to the required load. Okay, and it is itself is the regulated power supply. Okay. And in the next class, we'll see about the rectifiers here.